What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Dude Ranch DIY. My name is Chris, and today we are going to do a little bit more maintenance on Gorgonzola.
So I was going through my garage and I found some parts for the backhoe. This is a like knuckle guard that I'd like to put back on. I already went ahead and put on the hose protector or fitting protector. So that's going to get mounted. Another thing I'd like to do before the winter is take care of these old crusty lines. I'm not going to go too crazy just because it's not in the budget just yet. But this is the cylinder that we redid the last time you saw this. And these hoses have seen better days. The rubberized coating is just all dry rotted and flaking. The interior metal hose is pretty rusted. So this one's got to get replaced. This one looks fairly new-ish, definitely not from the 80s. So I'm going to leave that one. This one also looks relatively new, so I'll leave that. This one isn't showing really any signs of wear, so I'll leave that. And then over on this side, this one is showing a little bit of dry rot. This is the same, or these two are the same lines as the really bad one on the other side. Might as well just replace those. You can see it's starting to dry rot and crack off. They should be fine for now, but I would hate to be doing my driveway this winter and just have it all burst. So that's what we got on plan for today. Before I go to town with the little torch, I ran back up to the house and I grabbed a actual wrench, and hopefully I can get a little hold on this lower piece here. And now the fitting, and crack them free without having to use heat. I don't think it'll do anything to the fittings in a negative manner, but if I don't try, I feel like it'd be for naught. It's just a little awkward between placement and what needs to actually be done. Yeah, I don't see that happening. So we are gonna hit it with some heat, a little bit of TV blaster. Try to get something going on here. You can see we're getting hot already. There's got a little boil going of the PB blaster. For those of you that don't know, this little bit of heat is simply going to warm up the metal and make it expand, try and crack that little seal that the rust has made over the years. Usually it does the trick. Since I'm not looking to reuse this hose, I don't see this as being an issue. We'll find out when we look inside this fitting here. Now that it's nice and hot, we're gonna hit it with some PB again. Use some capillary action. That heat is gonna just take the PB blaster and suck it right up into the threads as it cools the metal. it's not working. It's still just bending this solid line. Get you guys out of the way a little bit. See if now I can fit this down in here like so. Oh man, that is tight.
Yes, you are tight like a tiger.
Oh baby. See that? Broke the seal. A little bit of heat goes a long way. Sweet. Man, that fitting is gnarly. Had a ton of corrosion all the way up to the JIC seal. No wonder that was so hard to peel off of there. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. I don't know if those are changeable or not. Might have to get this whole line redone.
So I got the three worst lines off. I'm not too happy about the way this fitting looks. It looks pretty corroded. So I don't know if I'm gonna have to get this whole line redone. So before I go taking off this cylinder so that I can pull this line, because I don't wanna heat up too close to this fitting here. I'm gonna take a run to Napa, get those three worst lines done, and see what they say about that bad JIC fitting, and report back.
So I asked the good old boys over at Napa what to do about this fitting. They told me basically it's over. I should really consider taking this line off and getting rid of it, putting a new line on. But I'm too cheap for that. I think as long as it doesn't leak, it'll be good enough for who it's for. So I reached out to my brother-in-law, who's a mechanic. He said just take a little wire brush and go nice and slow. Just get some of this corrosion off of here. Use a little PB blaster or, WD-40. And just clean it up. When you're done, throw a little pipe dope on it and it'll probably be good as new. If it does have an issue with leaking still, I can have him come down and help me out. He'll be able to cut this line on both sides, make a nice bevel, and stick in a new T-fitting for me. It's a little bit out of my mechanic comfort zone, but this should do. This rust is coming right off of this mating surface. And then the threads, as long as I can turn this the other way, I'll be able to clean those threads up nice. It's a less than ideal location for that to be, but we're getting it. Yeah, there's quite a bit of pitting. But like I said before, as long as it doesn't leak, it'll be good enough for who it's for. I really don't have the budget to replace this whole hard line and all the hoses as well, but you know, it is what it is. It's cleaned up. I will throw some of this pipe thread compound on there, and once the line is on, should be fine, right? That's what I'm going with. Now let's see, I didn't label anything, of course. This is much tackier. I prefer it that way, I guess. It's on there nice and tight.
Yes, you are tight like a tiger.
All right. I believe this is one of the ones that was leaking. Maybe I should pipe dope this now that I got the new lines. Alright, so we got one new line pipe doped and connected nice and tight. Two line on that cylinder. Nice and tight on the loader support and on the other cylinder as well. Now for the moment of truth, we'll see if everything's going all right here. I don't know for certain, but I think if the tractor is running, it is priming the system, building pressure. But the one way to make sure is to hit our fancy lever over here. Oh yeah. Got it up in the air, we're just gonna check for some leaks. They appear to be dry. Let's go around the other side. There's a bad O-ring. I think you guys actually pointed it out in the last video. I
that's just water. I think we can consider that a win. So this guy over here is a little bit wet on the top side here, but I can contribute that to a bad O-seal, O-ring, like you guys pointed out in the last video. This guy is dry, nice and dry. When I go to replace this or reseal this cylinder, I'll make sure that I get the proper O-rings for this. And this, I'll replace those. Over here on the front loader support, it appears to be dry. Can't quite tell, but we will see the next time I go to use it. There might be just a little puddle here, but that could be residual from the pipe dope. But that was also our worst JIC fitting. This guy appears to be nice and clean, nice and dry. I didn't touch this hose, but there appears to be a puddle there. I don't know if that's WD or not. PB Blaster, whatever I was using. And last, this is the cylinder that I've already rebuilt and was leaking before from this fitting. And that pipe dope seems to have helped down here, but there is still a little wet up on top. I'll contribute that to the bad O-ring that you guys were talking about. So I will get an O-ring kit. I will replace that, repipe dope it. And same with this one, just to be on the safe side. But I'm going to call that a win. This is a fun little tractor. I like working on it. I like tinkering, learning some new things. I'm hoping that the worst JIC fitting is savable. My brother-in-law says that he should be able to help me out with that should that become a problem, but I'm just going to keep an eye on it for now. It looks dry enough, definitely dry enough for who it's for. It's an old tractor. It's a 1989 Ford 1520, so you know, it's seen some time in the weather, seen some use, seen some work, and you know, I'm trying to give it the best life it can. I want it to last quite a few more years for myself, as did the other owner. But that's going to wrap it up for this one. I got nothing else for today, and I'm running out of time. So if you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, click that subscribe button down below. Questions, comments, feedback, anything that you want to call me out on, I will gladly take it. Anyway, this is Chris. You've been watching Dude Ranch DIY. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you here next time.